Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. I apologize about getting to these a week late. That is due to issues regarding my mouth, but I have the opportunity to sit down and catch up on the videos now. In the previous episode, we took a look at the new Soviet Mi-8 TV, which is coming to the Russian helicopter tree, as well as an export Mi-8 coming to the German helicopter tech tree. And now we're taking a look at another new ground vehicle. This one's actually kind of exciting too, because in an earlier dev blog for the next major update, we talked about the new Soviet 2S1 mobile artillery vehicle, which I talked about being, you know, familiar because it is also included as one of the vehicles, the medium artillery vehicle in World in Conflict. Well, then they go and announce this, the Chaparral, which is a new SAM anti-air guided missile vehicle, which is the SAM vehicle for the US faction in World in Conflict. So in one update, we get two vehicles that I'm very familiar with thanks to that game. Except in that game, they have the cover over, they have the canopy over the crew positioning on the front, but I guess in this game, they just wanted to go with no cover for it, probably so there isn't a dead zone, I'm assuming, for the SAM launcher. But regardless, the Chaparral is coming to two nations. It will be a rank 6 US SAM vehicle, and it will be a rank 7 Israeli SAM vehicle as well. So lots of vehicles coming to the game in the next major update that are going to multiple nations. But let's take a look. So the improved Chaparral SAM will help strengthen the ranks of the US and Israeli ground forces trees when it comes to War Thunder, the next major update. It is the improved Chaparral. It is a SAM SPAA for the United States of rank 6 and Israel of rank 7. It features two types of missiles to choose from, a thermal imager, 12 missiles on board, but lacks armor protection. And there is some history on the unit here if you are interested in learning more about it. It's definitely not that much of a looker, but I'm surprised that I kind of forgot about this thing. Most of the vehicles that I've played around with in other games or learned about through other games and stuff, I kind of always wanted to see in War Thunder, but for some reason I always forget about this, probably because if you ever play World in Conflict, not very often in the US campaign do you actually call down reinforcements via SAM, SPAA, in that game. There is one mission, though, where you can repair damaged Chaparrals that are AI-controlled that will then help defend against a Russian helicopter attack, but that's pretty much one of the only times I vividly remember ever using these things actively in the US campaign. The M163 is their light AA vehicle in that game, which of course we've had in War Thunder for a long time. The American-made Chaparral anti-aircraft missile system will appear in US and Israel ground forces research trees in the upcoming major War Thunder update. While the Chaparral does not come with its own radar, each missile can be guided through a normal sight that also features thermal imaging. Let's dive deeper into the details. We'd like to let you know that the incoming Chaparral will arrive at a different rank and battle rating within the US and Israeli research trees. This is because of the difference in available missiles. The Chaparral in the US tree will receive two types of surface-to-air missile, the default MIM-72A, which, interestingly enough, is an adapted AIM-9D Sidewinder, as well as the more advanced MIM-72E, which is available through researching this modification. While the Sidewinder will allow you to securely acquire targets from behind, the MIM-72E is an all-aspect seeker, which certainly makes it more devastating. The Chaparral in the Israeli tree will be located at rank 7, with the MIM-72E missile being available by default after purchasing the vehicle. Okay, I missed my line there. The more advanced MIM-72G missile will be available through researching this modification and offers a dual-channel IR-UV seeker with rosette scanning capabilities. The total number of missiles that the Chaparral can carry is 12, 4 on the launcher, and 8 in spares. Moving on to armor, the Chaparral uses an adapted version of the M548 cargo carrier chassis, which means there is virtually no armor to speak of. This means that the Chaparral can be penetrated just by rifle caliber machine guns. Because of the lack of armor, the Chaparral has a relatively low weight and allows it to reach up to 61 kilometers an hour on paved roads, as well as being able to move smoothly off roads. Four crew members sit perfectly next to each other in the vehicle with their arms out to their front, hence the title reference. Look for the new Chaparral anti-aircraft missile system in the US and Israeli Ground Forces research tree in the release of the upcoming update. And here we got some more screenshots with some desert camouflages to see. They don't seem to show the Israeli version here. They seem to just be showing the U.S. one, because as far as I'm aware, these are all U.S. camouflages. But it's an interesting new AA vehicle. And of course, like I said, I'm going to be a little bit biased towards it because it was another vehicle featured in another one of my favorite games. And now there's two from that game coming to this game at the same time. Of course, they're not from that game, but I mean, they were featured in that game. Of course, there's a lot of complaining because some nations are missing crucial anti-air vehicles right now, and now the United States is getting yet another anti-air vehicle for their high tier. I don't know so much about Israel, if they've got issues with their anti-air, since I've never actually played them yet, but I've definitely played up through the United States, and they've got plenty of anti-air options once you get past the M163 and into their SAM vehicles and stuff. They've got lots of different options in there. I'm not going to complain about another option, but I obviously can see people's concerns about countries like Japan not having a lot of options to pick and choose from. But apparently they are working on something for Japan, some sort of anti-air vehicle, so we'll just have to wait and see what they end up getting in the end. Whether that's going to be for this update or another next major update, I don't know for sure. But there you go. That is the new anti-air vehicle coming to two nations in the game, and next we'll be looking at whatever else is coming in the next major update.